Hi, I'm Jason from Ooma, and this video will explain how to install Ooma AirDial. Ooma AirDial is a comprehensive solution for replacing legacy analog phone lines, also known as POTS lines. These POTS lines are typically used to provide phone service to specialty equipment such as elevators, fire and burglar alarm panels, building entry systems, fax machines, emergency call boxes, and more. In addition to describing AirDial installation, this video will show you how to identify the internal wiring that connects equipment to AirDial, how to test the connected equipment, and more. Here are some of the specialized tools you may need, in addition to the standard tools for wiring work. 1. A telephone test set, also known informally as a butt set. 2. A tone generator kit for tracing wires. 3. A punch-down tool for connecting wires to a termination block, also known as a 66 block or 110 block. 4. Tools needed for splicing and crimping RJ11 jacks to twisted pair wiring or connecting to a surface mount box, also known as a biscuit jack. For a more detailed list, visit help.ooma.com. Let's start with planning and scheduling. Arrange a time to meet with the building owner or facilities manager. Let them know that you will need contact information for any fire or burglar alarm monitoring companies. Also, let them know you will need access to wiring closets and telco rooms. Most buildings will have a room or closet that is the MPOE, or minimum point of entry. This is where the POTS wiring from the phone company enters the building. It may also be called the demarcation point, or DMARC. This room will usually have a punch-down termination block that connects the old wires from the phone company to the internal wiring. If AirDial devices were shipped directly to the site, make sure in advance that the facilities manager knows where they are being stored. Have a list of the phone numbers of the old POTS lines that are being replaced. This should be included in the scope of work, or SOW, if you're a professional installer working for Ooma. It's also helpful to have a list of the equipment that is being disconnected from the old POTS lines and reconnected to AirDial, although this may not always be known in advance. On the day of installation, arrive at least 15 minutes prior to the scheduled installation time. Start with a property tour with the on-site contact. Ensure that you will have access to each area where entry is required to complete the installation, including the MPOE or DMARC. Locate all equipment to be connected to the AirDial service. For each piece of connected equipment, you will want to, first, take photos of the equipment. This includes fire panels, burglar alarm panels, gate boxes, and elevators. Make sure the photos show the make and model of the equipment, if possible. Also take a photo of any external dialers. Second, test that the equipment is operational before converting it from its current POTS connection to AirDial. Test the connected equipment at least twice. Once when you arrive, before moving it from POTS to AirDial, and then again after moving it to AirDial. In some cases, you may need to test a third time after any number porting is complete. Here is how to test different types of equipment. For elevators, place a call from the elevator cab. Make sure the call connects. Don't hang up before the operator answers. When the operator answers, tell them that you're performing a test and that there is no emergency. For fire and burglar alarms, you may require customer involvement. You'll need to call the customer's alarm monitoring service or have the on-site contact do so while you're present. There are 4 steps to testing. Step 1, verify alarm status panel shows normal or in service. Step 2, have the alarm service provider put the device in test mode. You'll need the account number and PIN. Sometimes this info is on the alarm box itself. If the panel does not show normal or in service, then contact Ooma support for troubleshooting steps. Step 3, sometimes an alarm company will ask how long the system should be in test mode. Explain that the installer or customer will call at the conclusion of installation to end test mode. Step 4, which happens only after cutover to AirDial is completed. The field tech or the customer should inform the alarm company of the panel's new phone number. When testing fax machines, create a 1-page black and white test page. Send the test page to 888-473-2963, which is HP's fax test number. Then wait 5 to 7 minutes for the service to send a return fax. For door or gate entry systems, arrange to place a test call to the site's office or other on-site contact. When the call connects, explain that I'm an installer testing the line. Please confirm the phone number that you see on caller ID. If the system has a feature to dial a DTMF tone to open the door or gate, then test that it opens. For call boxes and other voice use cases, make a test call from the customer equipment and ensure the call is completed successfully. You will need to determine where each of the customer equipment lines terminate in order to know where to place the AirDial units. When all equipment connected to AirDial is in the same room, it can be plugged in directly to the AirDial unit. Simply connect the RJ11 jack coming from the equipment into the appropriate FXS port on AirDial. More often, the AirDial will need to be installed in a telco closet where the phone lines from on-site equipment terminate. In this case, you'll need to identify the appropriate line to connect to AirDial. Sometimes the lines on the punch-down termination block will be labeled. Typically, however, the lines will not be labeled and will require tracing. This can be broken down into tracing external lines coming from the street and internal lines connected to equipment at the site. To identify external lines, you can use a telephone test set to determine which lines correspond to which phone numbers. Connect alligator clips to the binding posts on the punch-down termination block. Dial your cell phone number. You'll see that external line's number on your caller ID. Or you can dial 1-800-444-4444 from your test set and hear the phone number read aloud. To identify internal lines, you can use a toner to trace the lines. Go to each piece of equipment that needs to be traced. Disconnect the phone line from the equipment and put the tone generator portion of the toner on the line. Then use the probe portion to search for which wire at the punch-down termination block is hot. For more information on phone line toning, there are many instructional videos on YouTube. If you're not able to find an internal piece of equipment or an external phone number that is in your work order, consult with your supervisor. Now we're going to unbox an Ooma AirDial. And the lid opens to reveal a few pieces of information that will be used during the setup. So here we have the AirDial unit itself with a bit of information on the front and back. We've got an AC power brick and the cord to connect it. Two panel antennas that will be attached to the top of the box. We've got an Ethernet cable to hardwire it to any pieces of to the internet. We've got four telephone wires to connect equipment to the back of the box, and some screws and mounting brackets to put it onto a wall. I'm going to give a peek at the list of items that should be included with the AirDial, and it seems that they're all here, and you can proceed to setup steps as outlined in the manual. Your AirDial unit should come with two antennas, an AC power brick, and four RJ11 cables. If your unit came with antennas of different sizes, mount the wide paddle-shaped antenna on the right side when facing the unit. The AirDial unit may or may not already be configured. To find out, turn on the AirDial using the power switch. Wait at least 5 minutes. When the device is fully booted, the LCD screen will display status in service. If the top line of the LCD does not say in service, then the device is either not activated or not able to get an internet connection. Refer to the section of this video on activating the device in RDM to ensure the device is activated. At this point, make sure the current location has sufficient LTE signal. Since AirDial is battery powered, you can walk around with the device in hand to determine wireless coverage using the signal strength indicator on the LCD display. There's more information on LTE signal and placement later in the video. Once the device is in service, connect a telephone test set to each FXS port and test inbound and outbound calls to and from your cell phone on all active ports. Confirm the caller ID on the AirDial LCD screen matches what you see on your cell phone. The location of the AirDial device is important and should take into account the following. It should be near where the internal wiring terminates. In some cases, multiple AirDial devices may be needed. It should have an AC power outlet nearby, have good LTE signal strength, and be protected from being accidentally disturbed or moved. To ensure the best possible LTE signal strength, here are the do's and don'ts. Do, place the AirDial as high as possible in a room. Place the AirDial in or near a window if possible. And make sure the antennas are oriented vertically. They will not perform as well if tilted diagonally or horizontally. Do not place the AirDial near large solid metal objects such as steel beams, electrical cabling, sheet metal, wire mesh, plumbing, or equipment racks, and do not allow the antennas to touch any other object. Safety information on Ooma AirDial is available on our support site. Go to help.ooma.com. If you're experiencing signal issues, we encourage you to disconnect the AirDial from AC power and move around with it on battery power while observing the signal strength indicator on the LCD. 1 bar of signal strength is usually sufficient for making calls on AirDial. Contact customer support if you're unsure about signal conditions. There are additional steps that can be taken to find better signal strength, including changing SIM cards, installing different antennas, and more. If the customer will use on-site internet as the primary connection for AirDial, you will need to connect an Ethernet cable from the customer's switch or router to the AirDial. Use the port labeled WAN. With this setup, the WAN Ethernet will be the primary connection and LTE will be used if the wired internet connection fails. When multiple AirDials require Ethernet connections, use an unmanaged switch. Once you have located lines and found a suitable location for one or more AirDial devices, you can connect the customer equipment to the AirDial FXS port and test it. For equipment that terminates to a block, you can run a new wire pair from the block to AirDial or remove the wire pair from the block and connect the pair directly to AirDial. You have 2 options to terminate the wiring to AirDial. 1, crimp an RJ11 connector to the end of the wire from the equipment. Connect the RJ11 to the AirDial FXS port. Or 2, use a surface mount block, also known as a biscuit jack. Connect the wires per the instructions on the jack, then use one of the included phone cables to connect the biscuit jack to the AirDial FXS port. Keep track of the original POTS line to which the equipment was connected in case you need to revert to the old POTS line for troubleshooting. We recommend you label them for this purpose. After you've connected the first piece of equipment to AirDial, you should test it. Refer to the earlier section of the video describing how to test connected equipment. Test each piece of equipment after it is cut over before moving on to the next one. Refer to the previous section of the video for more information about how to test specific types of connected equipment. An important note, when cutting over fire alarms from POTS to AirDial, you must notify the fire alarm monitoring service in advance. The service must put the panel in test mode before you remove the existing POTS line connection. If you are a professional Ooma installer, you should report status for each cutover on your work order. If porting numbers, call Ooma support at 833-307-4247 and provide the master ticket number from the work order. Porting can take up to 14 days to complete. In some cases, the porting will be coordinated in advance to happen at the same time as installation. If equipment is cut over from POTS to AirDial before the port is completed, and the equipment needs to receive calls from the number being ported, set up a forwarding rule on the old POTS line to forward all incoming calls to the new AirDial number. Once you have confirmed successful operation of equipment connected to AirDial, you can mount the AirDial unit. Try to maintain a distance of at least 1 foot between AirDial and other electrical equipment or metal devices. Ensure that nothing is touching the antennas and that they are oriented vertically. Ensure that there is no weight on the AC connector cord. Mount the AC adapter to the wall if necessary. If you're a professional Ooma installer, or if you are a customer who purchased your AirDial directly from Ooma, the AirDial devices will likely be pre-activated. If not, You'll need to activate them using the Remote Device Management, or RDM, portal, which is an easy-to-use Ooma web application available on any device with a browser. RDM allows you to monitor and manage AirDial devices from anywhere. Access RDM at rdm.ooma.com. First, create a login with your email address and password. Then create a new customer account. Choose Activate Device and follow the instructions. More information on RDM configuration is available at help.ooma.com. Once an AirDial device is activated and online, you can manage and monitor it from the Remote Device Management, or RDM, cloud portal. The device list view shows the status of all your devices at a quick glance. If you manage AirDial installations for multiple customers, you can quickly switch between accounts at the top right. You can search, filter, and sort the device list view by any column. You can configure individual FXS ports in the Device Details screen. You can also set up email and SMS notifications for events such as the device going offline or onto battery power. For each line on AirDial, you can view the logs of incoming, outgoing, and missed calls. This may be useful when testing and troubleshooting connected equipment. You can invite additional users to access an RDM account from the Users tab. You're also able to assign new user permissions as an administrator, user, or editor. You can always use RDM from a mobile browser at the same URL, rdm.ooma.com. Find more information on RDM at help.ooma.com. If you have any questions about Ooma AirDial, Ooma has an extensive knowledge base with detailed information on installation and management of AirDial devices. Visit help.ooma.com or call 833-603-4247 for assistance. We're always glad to help.